Hey, what's up everyone, and welcome to another video, and this time I'm going to give you my first impressions on a little thing called a Nintendo Switch. That's right, I got one. You probably already know that because the last few days I've been posting many things regarding the Nintendo Switch, gore plays for games and unboxings and stuff like that, and I am here to tell you my first impressions. I've played approximately 10 hours of the new Zelda game, and about, I would say, around 5 hours of other stuff, as well as just messing around on the UI of the Nintendo Switch, which is very sparse, which I'll get to in a second. But I would say around 15 hours has been spent doing stuff on this system. So I am really, really happy to announce that I am very, very, very impressed with this system. I really, really like it so far. First of all, when it comes to portability, it works perfectly, just like advertised. You take it anywhere you go, you play it, it feels good in your hands when you're playing it like this, or when you're taking the Joy-Cons off and putting it on this grip right here. It works perfectly, in my opinion. Perfect. I was playing Zelda, I was completing shrines without any problems or anything. I wasn't distracted by stuff. I wasn't annoyed because the controls were weird or something like that while I was playing like this. I wasn't annoyed when playing it with the grip or anything. It was perfectly fine. So when it comes to controls and the buttons and stuff and how everything feels here, it feels very well made, very sturdy, and I really like it. And I haven't really had any problems with any like desyncing with the Joy-Con on the left, which I've heard there's a lot of complaints with that. I've had some problems with Bomberman, I will say. Not with the Joy-Con, but I think it's more like the online is laggy. Like, there's actually some, like, lag issues with there. Like, you can press left and your character will start moving left, like, maybe half a second later and stuff. Or maybe not even, like, maybe, like, a quarter of a second later. But I don't even think that was a problem with the Joy-Con. I think that's just a problem with the online itself. But overall, the screen itself looks nice. Yeah, I'll turn it on, but you can probably not really see much. You know, my camera's not the best out there. But it's a nice screen, very, very nice quality, 720p, not 1080p, but that's fine. On this little screen, I mean, it doesn't really matter. It looks beautiful. And I would say stuff like Zelda looks absolutely gorgeous on it. Like, I'm not actually playing it, I'm on the title screen, but it looks gorgeous. Very vibrant, very colorful. The colors really do pop on this thing, and it's very bright. Even when you're in daylight, you don't really have much of a problem seeing. I was playing in daylight the other day, and it was fine. I had to turn the brightness up a little bit, but for the most part, it was fine. There was no real bad glare. I could see what I was doing. It was perfect, in my opinion. So overall, when it comes to the portability of this system, and playing outside and stuff, and the controls and whatnot, it is perfect. It really is. It's a great console for that. Just, I wish there was a lot more games. I get it. Zelda's going to take you a long time to complete, but even if it takes you a month to complete this game, which I could see that definitely, after a month, there really isn't even anything else in the span of now and, what, I guess April 5th or whatever. Like, whatever today is, was it April 6th? I mean, what, you have Binding of Isaac, which looks fun, but we have all played Binding of Isaac. There's a Pocket Rumble, there's a couple of games, but nothing really too big. Like, there's no other big experience in the next month. Mario Kart comes out at the end of April, and then you have Redout, which looks pretty cool. But besides that, there's not much else. So, even though this is a great portable system, I highly recommend it for that. I don't really recommend it right this second, because there's not many games for it. And even Zelda you could play on Wii U. If you have a Wii U, I definitely don't recommend this, because Zelda is the definite, this is the game you should get. If you don't get this game, you're getting 1-2 Switch and Bomberman, and even some of the other really good games like, Bomberman is pretty good, but Fast RMX or Snipper Clips, I still don't recommend it for those games. I recommend it for this, especially if you don't have a Wii U. If you do have a Wii U, hold off, just get it on Wii U. It's perfectly fine from what I've heard on Wii U. It looks almost at the exact same. There's some frame rate drops here and there, more consistent on the Wii U than on the Switch. But from what I've heard, it's not that big of a deal. You'll still really enjoy this game on the Switch. You just can't take it everywhere you go, which is the problem. But if you really want something that's portable, if you really need something that's portable and you want to play the new Zelda, then go right ahead. Go ahead. It's still a fine system, and the other games, even though expensive, are still really fun too. So portability-wise, this is definitely a console you should get if you really need a new portable system. Like, if you're someone that spends most of their time outside of your house. You know, I mean most of your time. Like, you come home and go to sleep and that's it. You know, then definitely get this. But if you are someone that, you know, spends a decent amount of time at home, then just get the Wii U version. If you have a Wii U. So yeah, the screen itself is very, very high quality. It looks beautiful, especially Zelda. The controls themselves work very well if you're keeping it on the system or you're putting on this grip right here, or even if you're just holding one in each hand. It works very well. The buttons are very sturdy. There's a nice little click to them. You can't, maybe you can't hear it, but they feel good. It's all good, baby. It really is. It's all good. The buttons and controls are great on the system, in my opinion. And even playing it on the TV, docking it, and then using that grip, it works well. Like, I was really surprised that I didn't have to run out and buy that Pro Controller. Because I played about the 10 hours I played of Zelda, I played about maybe 3 hours on this, and then about 7 hours on my big screen, and that means I used this grip right here, and it worked perfectly. It really did. I never felt like I was, you know, dying because of the controller, or I wasn't having fun because the button placement's weird. I was perfectly fine with it. It really is a great controller when you put it in the grip, and each one of these are great by themselves. When you're playing multiplayer games and you have to use one each, you know, like if you have a friend over and you want to play Bomberman, you give him the red one, you keep this one, so you take it off the system and you dock it, or you put it on whatever, you use this kickstand, this crappy-ass kickstand to put it on the table, and then you play on the little screen, whatever you do. And then you use one of these, even this, you know, playing a split-screen game or Bomberman or whatever, or a fast RMX, this, it works. It works very well. It doesn't feel too small for my hands, and I got big monster hands, like, you know, I could grab my whole head. I'm not going to do it, though. But this is a small controller, but it doesn't feel that small. It really doesn't. When I saw this in the commercial, I was like, oh, come on. Like, them all playing, like, an NBA game or something, or them playing Mario Kart. I'm like, there's no way in hell. Like, first-person shooters will never work with this thing. That's just right there. Like, unless they use this D-pad right here, or wherever these buttons, as, like, the way to move your reticle or whatever. It will never work unless, like, somehow, some way they make like a peripheral which gives you a second nub, just like they did with the 3DS. I don't see that ever happening. But Mario Kart, that'll definitely work. Stuff like Bomberman, stuff like Fast RMX, those games work. NBA will probably work. You know, stuff that doesn't have camera angles, pretty much. That those will all work. So, you know, this is definitely a really good system to get if you want portability and you want something that immediately comes with two controllers and you can play with a friend. If you want something like that, definitely. I highly recommend it for that. And look how easily this switches back into there. That's very satisfying. I've done that countless times, just randomly, like, I want to take this controller off and put it back on. Yeah, I don't know why. It's satisfying. So yeah, overall controls, screen, it's great so far. All right, now we get to my problem with the Switch, and it's not really a huge problem, but it's something that I have to talk about, and that is this thing, the dock. The dock itself is, as you can tell, a hunk of plastic. There's barely anything to this. I think there's a little bit of a motherboard right here. You can't see it. It's in the plastic shell, but that's all it is. It's just a little motherboard. Everything else is plastic, really, and you can see, like, there's little, things to align your Switch with. So you can play it on TV, and you do it like this. You put it in there. I'm not going to put it in. Yeah, I'll put it in. You do it like this, and then it immediately goes on the TV. What I have a problem with is every time I put this in there, I feel like I'm about to mess up the screen badly. And I don't. I've seen countless people put this in their thing and just scratch the hell out of it. And I'm so worried one day I'm going to put it in there, in that dock, and scratch the hell out of the screen. And that is a problem. Many people have done it already. Many. Okay? And I'm assuming all these are made with the same material. So, maybe mine's made out of adamantium. I don't know. It doesn't feel like metal. Also, that's not a real thing, I don't think. That's just comic book shit. But it's not made out of any sort of different material, I don't think. So, I get worried every time, and that's the main problem, is that there's going to be one time where I'm just like, alright, let's play, I put it in there, I play a little bit, and I take it out, and I realize there's a huge scratch on my freaking system. I'm going to be so pissed. So yeah, get a screen protector. That's one thing I could say about this. Get a screen protector. Even that, I've had experiences where I had screen protectors and I still had a scratched up screen. So hopefully it's like some really good screen protector, because you most likely will need it, especially if you switch in and out of TV and the switch screen itself. So that's my main problem, is this dock is very cheap. I will give it credit, though. It does try to keep everything organized well. Like, it has this little flap, like I showed earlier. And here's all the connections, HDMI, here's a USB. If you need to use that, AC adapter. They try to keep it organized, so you put all the cables in here, and then you slam this door shut, and then you keep the cables out right here. So it does try to keep things organized. It's not like there'll just be three wires coming out of the back of it, you know, just like spread apart. They do try to keep it a little bit organized, so I'll give them that. Also, even though it looks pretty cheap, at least it has like the logo switch here and the Nintendo Switch thing there, so it doesn't just look like a black hunk of plastic. At least you can look at it and go, that's the Switch, baby. Ah, yeah. And that sounds like the lamest positive I can give. Alright, so now let's get on to the UI of this thing. The UI, the user interface, for people that don't know what that means, is pretty lame. I'm not gonna lie. It's very not Nintendo, and I get what they're trying to do. I really do. They're trying to make it look more like a tablet, where a tablet has a very, you know, very, I would say, clean UI. Even though on a tablet or a phone or whatever, you can add all these different apps, so you have all these different things. This doesn't really have that. There's no YouTube. There's no Netflix. There's no internet browser. There's nothing like that. There's actually no apps at all besides the games themselves. And this is what it looks like. I don't know if you can see, but I'm sure you can find pictures of it in higher quality. But this is pretty much all you get. You get news, so it tells you all the news. It gives you an eShop, so you can go to the eShop, which is also a very, very sterile looking menu. Very, very not complex at all. It's not like the shops on the Xbox or the PS4 or whatever. You get a place for your album, which is one thing I didn't mention, is that the left Joy-Con has a capture button, which is really cool, so you can actually capture in-game screenshots at any time you want, just like the PS4 has on its controller. Controller, so you can link different controllers. System settings, so you can go in there and create your Miis or switch TV resolutions or whatever, or add new users and stuff like that. And of course, you know, options and stuff like that. Brightness, you can change there. And it has a sleep mode, and that's pretty much all you have. You can also go to your user page. So here's my page. Here's my friend code if you want to add me. You probably can't see that. I'll put it in the description if you want to add me. And you can look at your friends playing. Everybody's playing Legend of Zelda. Big surprise there. And you can add a friend, and you can go to user settings through here as well. And that's about it. There's not much to it. There's no Netflix. There's no nothing like that. Hell, you can't even put your own background on this thing. Like, you either have a white background, which I don't recommend because it's blinding, or a black background like I do, which is better on the eyes. And that's really it. When it comes to UI, it's very simple, very clean, very, very, very minimal. And there's not even, like, any sounds. Like, here, I'll turn the volume up. You hear anything? No? The only thing you'll hear is when I go to my page, or when you're moving over things, you can hear stuff there. But when you go to your page, it plays this. So it does like a Marco Polo thing, which is weird. At least that's what it sounds like. It's like Marco Polo. That's what it sounds like to me. I don't know what else that could be. But that's it. There's no music. There's no nice little Wii music or Wii U music or whatever. There's no big intro like in the Wii U when you turn the console on. You see all these people just like, all these Miis just run out and stuff. And you see all these games being played and Miiverse stuff. That's another thing I'm really upset. No Miiverse, which I really enjoy Miiverse myself. But, yeah. I mean, it's very, very not Nintendo, I feel. Nintendo is always like personality and weird stuff and whatever, and this just feels like a tablet. That's what it, I mean, I know that's what it kind of is, but I just wish it had, you know, I wish it was a tablet that had the Nintendo stuff besides just a tablet that plays Nintendo, and that's it. I don't know. That's my main criticism with it. I mean, I know that this was also my main criticism, but this was my main criticism of the dock. My main criticism of the Switch is the UI. The controls are fine, everything's good, it looks beautiful, screen's great, the games themselves, even though minimum, are really fun. It's just this UI. I hope they add more to it. Also, the touchscreen works fine, you know, it works like a touchscreen. no big thing here. There's nothing really too innovative about this system besides that you could take it anywhere. I know that's innovative, but there's nothing like, you know, like the dual screens of the DS. There's nothing that's brand new, you know, like, whoa, like nobody thought of that. Like we, you know, people thought of motion controls, but they made it popular. I don't see this becoming extremely popular with certain, you know, other companies like, you know, Xbox or whatever. I don't see Xbox doing something like this or PlayStation. I don't think Nintendo's going to revolutionize games in the future because of this, or change the way games are because of, you know, you could take it anywhere. I don't think that's going to happen. I think just people are going to be, like, really happy that they could take Zelda on the road. That's about it. But anyway, there you go. That's my first impressions of the Switch. I really love it. I really do. I have almost no complaints. Of course, probably right after I do this video and post it up, I'm going to have some problems with it. That's usually how it works at this point. Like, I'm playing it, and then it's going to freeze my game, and then the screen's going to turn black, and there's going to be, like, really screechy noises like everybody else has been having, or, I don't know, my Joy-Con's going to explode, or, I don't know, the Switch is going to explode and blow my head off, or, I don't know, who knows? Zelda's going to look at me and say, you're a fucking idiot, and then Link's going to stab me with a sword. Who knows what's going to happen in the future, man? This fucking thing, man... anything could happen. I've seen so many different problems with this, and it's only been out for a couple days. Who knows what could happen? But for now, I have to give this, if I had to give a score from a 0 to a 10, I would give this an 8.5 out of 10. I think it is a great system. It works very well. Games are minimum. The UI itself is sparse, and the dock is not well made at all, and I'm scared for the future of this thing. But, it's a great system. It really is. And Zelda's amazing. And I'll do a review for that, or first impressions at least. So anyway, there you go. I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you, and until next time, goodbye.